tolerance ratio. Technically, it is precision gauge R&R is precision tolerance ratio. What is precision? Sum of repeatability error and reproducibility error. What is tolerance? The tolerance range which customer gives you, USL minus LSL. Customer has given you some tolerance range, USL minus LSL, and your error is so much percentage of the tolerance range. And this is what we call it gauge R&R, the precision tolerance ratio. This range, as this error has to be less than 10% to consider your measurement system as capable, as well as your measurement system should be adequate. Adequate in the sense, it should work fine throughout the range of the measurement. It should work fine throughout the range of the measurement, from the lower reading to the, you know, the larger reading. It should work with the same accuracy, I would say, right? The bias should be same. So NDC monitors that. NDC should be 5, gauge R&R should be less than 10%. In case your measurement system error is more than 30%, we outrightly reject the measurement system and we don't proceed with the data collection. Under such situation, you have to reduce the measurement error. Or even if it is in the 10 to 30% category, we call it conditionally acceptable. Under such situation also, we have to reduce the measurement error. If we can't reduce, we have to change the measurement system. And if you really wanted to reduce the measurement error, then you must know the root of the error. For that, the gauge R&R report, once you have the ready-made data available, the gauge R&R report can, you can refer to the gauge R&R report. You can create 6 types of graph, and each graph can give you wonderful information, and that is what I'm going to teach you now. All right. So these are the 6 graphs. Hope all the 6 graphs all of you can see. The first graph is a bar chart. The second graph is a control chart, particularly X bar chart. Third graph is also a control chart, particularly it is, I'm sorry, this is R chart and this is X bar chart. And then the fourth one is response by part. You can call it a dot plot. You see a lot of dots here. And then the dots are also connected by line. So it's a dot plot. And this is a box plot. You see 3 boxes. So it's called a box plot. And again, it's a dot plot, you know, with a combination of line. So each and every graph is going to give us beautiful information about what is going wrong in our measurement system. Why a lot of error is happening. The first one gives broader picture of variation. What is broader picture of variation? Variation can be from the process. Variation can be from the measurement. So which is higher, process variation or measurement variation? If measurement variation is higher than the process variation, do you think you can control the process variation? No. If you really want to, you know, solve your problem of your friend, and you should be, first of all, no problem free. With you having a lot of problem and advising your friend may not work effectively. Same way, when your measurement system has a lot of variation and using that measurement system to reduce a process variation, no, is not a great idea. And that is what this graph is telling you. And now there are 3 colors. We will talk about each and everything. And the third one is called part-to-part variation. What is part-to-part variation? This is result of process variation. The first one is measurement variation, gauge R&R. And which is taller here, part-to-part or the measurement variation? Part-to-part. That means your problems are less compared to your friend's problem. Now you can advise him. But when you see the gauge R&R is more than the part-to-part, you can straight away understand you have an inadequate and an incapable measurement system. Don't know. Your project cannot succeed. So that's the thing you can understand. And within the measurement error, it is further divided into repeatability and reproducibility. So which is higher, you get a fair idea. The second one, it checks the appraiser's repeatability. The R chart checks the appraiser's repeatability. And the X bar chart checks the ability of your measurement system to differentiate good and bad. And the response by part, this chart checks the part-wise reproducibility of appraiser. This box plot checks the overall reproducibility of the appraiser. And finally, this particular plot, also called as interaction plot, checks whether any specific part appraiser combination is affecting the measurement system. Any particular combination, right? So that's, we call it interaction. We'll touch that interaction in the analyze also. Now we'll see all these graphs one by one. First graph, component of variation. There are three colors, blue color, red color, and yellow color. And now the blue color works on the variance. Blue color works on the variance. So we have taught you everything based on the standard deviation. So you can ignore the blue color. You can ignore the blue color. And between red and yellow, when to use red and when to use yellow. Both works on the standard deviation. Because it is only based on the standard deviation, we are telling you the guideline that less than 10% your measurement system is great. More than 10%, 10 to 30 conditionally good. More than 30 definitely not valid. So it is, everything is based on standard deviation. So you can refer or read only the red or the yellow. And red you can use if the customer tolerance is not defined. Some situation you may not have customer tolerance. But many situation, you will know what is the USL and what is the LSL. Otherwise, you know the range of your data. So, once the USL and LSL are known, you can refer to the yellow. When you don't know, when you don't give those input to Minitab, then Minitab will automatically consider steady variation as the denominator, which is nothing but the maximum value minus minimum value. So, hope all of you are with me on this. So, we will always know the USL and LSL. So I recommend you to refer to the yellow graph. Now looking at the yellow graph here and here, which is more, gauge R&R is more or part to part is more? Part to part is more. Process variation is more. The problem due to the process is more and problem due to the measurement is less. This is the ideal situation. If it gets reversed, you really cannot do a project better. No, don't progress your project, right? Because you ask for a better measurement system. And now gauge R&R, it is somewhere around 30 or something. And now which is dominating? Whether it is repeatability is dominating or reproducibility is dominating? Can somebody tell me which is dominating? Is it repeatability or reproducibility?
Repeatability.
So your focus should be on more. Our focus should be more on reducing the repeatability. So this gives only the broader picture of what is exactly going wrong. Now, repeatability is a major concern. And of course, reproducibility is also, comparatively, on the same magnitude, but it is slightly low. So this is how the first graph is helping you. Same way, graph by graph, if you read, you will understand the root of the problem. Why gauge R&R is more than 30%? Is it repeatability is killing you or reproducibility is killing you? So what is repeatability? The error committed by the single appraiser. If the appraiser himself doesn't repeat his readings consistently, and that is what you call it, repeatability error. And every operator can contribute to this. Every operator can contribute to this. And reproducibility error. What is reproducibility error? The error between the appraiser. When there are five people who are collecting data for your project, same data, but five people are collecting, there is a chance that they can disagree between each other. And now that disagreement, what we call it as reproducibility. Let us say in your team, there are five people. Four people are measuring in a particular way. And the fifth person is measuring in a completely different way. And now who is contributing for the reproducibility error? The fifth person. You have to align with the team to bring down the reproducibility. You have to align with your own readings when you are repeating the measurement. So that is repeatability. If you disagree within yourself, that is repeatability. If you disagree between the other appraisers, then it is reproducibility. So this only gives a broader picture. The remaining five graphs we'll see after the tea break.
Sir, I have one doubt, sir.
Yes, please.
If the process is one side tolerant, yes, sir. For example, one splice is only butt splice. That means maximum one side tolerance.
Okay.
In that case, how to proceed, sir?
In that case, what is your, anyway, see, for example, I'm conducting the exam. What is the pass mark?
60%.
So above 60, it's not a problem for me. Am I right?
Yes.
But below 60 is a problem. Now what is your LSL?
LSL is not there. Specification given as maximum 2 mm.
Okay, so, maximum 2 mm.
Shall I consider that 0 LSL?
Yes, that's all. That's all. LSL is 0, USL is 2 mm. That's all. Okay. Very good.
Okay. You're right. And one more, sir. If I'm having vernier, 300 mm vernier, total process in my soft floor is having 5 vernier uses, in uses.
Okay.
So, how can I take the sample for R and R study? If I'll go for all 5 or anyone with that range.
You mean you have 5 vernier, right?
Yes, sir.
You have 5 vernier. All are having the same least count?
List count same.
Right. And if you really have a doubt whether one particular vernier may give you, you know, error.
Okay.
And you don't know which particular vernier is giving you a problem.
Yes.
Now what should you do? You must
collect all the vernier and decide.
You must use, you are now trying to actually validate the vernier.
Okay. Sorry,
because your problem is now reduced only to the vernier. Mm-hmm. And now all 5 vernier you must use to understand which is giving a reading different from, the more different from the true value. And see, the equipment problem, it directly, it talks about the accuracy. So you can calibrate all the 5. You can calibrate all the 5 and, make everything, uniform. If you have 5 vernier, probably you will calibrate all the 5 together, and the calibration procedure, calibration frequency, everything will be same, isn't it?
Yes, yes.
So this is a rare situation where, you doubt only about a particular vernier. And if that is the question, then you must have all 5. If that is not a question, generally that such question should not exist, because we should make sure all our equipments are calibrated.
Yes.
Should make sure all our equipments are calibrated at appropriate frequency. And thereby, bias, linearity, stability, all are taken care. If all are taken care, and then only the gauge R&R study, your precision study happens.
Yes.
So, I think your question is related to the accuracy, not the precision.
Oh, sir, that is clear. My doubt is, when I am putting an annual plan for MSA plan, I will go for all 5 vernier or any one. Same range, same discount.
See, if all are having the same discount, all are having the same level of accuracy, you really feel all 5 you have to do it?
But practically not possible, sir.
Practically not possible. See, you should be able to, divide your approach into 2. One is accuracy-related problem.
Okay.
What is accuracy-related problem?
Okay.
2 value is 100,
but
your reading is 105.
100, yeah.
Now, this is an accuracy problem. If you are worried about accuracy problem, I suggest you include all 5 and then make all 5 equally accurate and more accurate.
Okay, sir.
Another problem can come. What is another problem? Precision.
Precision.
You have given me 100 mm, but I am giving you 105 reading. I am not accurate. But you wanted me to measure it 3 times. And all 3 times when I give you the same 105, my readings are not accurate, but I am precise.
Yes.
You understand?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
But when 100 mm is given to me, I measure it as 105 first time, and second time I measure it as 110, and third time I measure it as 115. Besides me being inaccurate, I am also not precise.
Yes, yes.
So this more dangerous is not precise.
Not precise.
Because not accurate, solution is there. Calibrate it, that's all.
Yes. Yes,
my watch is 10 minutes fast. I can set the time properly.
Yes.
I can set it back to give me the correct time. That's called calibration.
Yes.
But precision, it's complex phenomena. You cannot simply figure out it is equipment. You can't simply tell, it is the operator. You can't tell it is, mainly the environment. It can be the combination.
Yes, sir.
So analysis is required. Clear?
Clear, sir. Yeah. Thank you.
Right. I think we'll take the attendance here and also go for the tea break and then continue by 11:15. And the remaining 5 graphs I will explain.
Okay.
Can you all please come on video?